A couple who lost their two-year-old daughter in flooding after Cyclone Gabrielle have shared their anguish and their anger because they now believe more could have been done to avert the tragedy. They've spoken exclusively to our Hawke's Bay reporter, Henry McMullen.
The earth should be healing and water should cleanse, but that which once brought me comfort like an old friend now offers no solace nor condolence or mend.
A grieving mum's poem for her daughter, Ivy, swept away in February's floods.
We've got a friend that brings flowers every couple of weeks and leaves them here, always with a little bit of ivy.
This was the two-year-old's bedroom, glow-in-the-dark stars still on the ceiling.
A cruel reminder of a very happy time.
They say when they went to bed on the night of the storm, they felt reassured.
The last thing I looked at online when I went to bed was a statement that had been put out saying that they were on high alert, that they were fully staffed through the night.
But by midnight, rivers had risen to record levels. There was no evacuation order. In the early hours of the morning, floodwaters were surging through the Esk Valley.
It was bloody hell on earth. I couldn't put it in any other terms. It was just hell. I came up in the middle of the night into a sea of hell.
The family had to swim for their lives. Jack carried four-year-old Imogen. Ella, who was pregnant, took toddler Ivy.
I managed to get Imogen off my shoulders onto this hedge.
At which point
Ella had...
I just screamed and I said, I've lost her. And when the water came, it was... I lost my footing and I went under. And it's, as Jack says, just lifted up off my shoulders.
Just washed her straight
off. I came up just in time to see her floating away. If we had been told to get out of there, we'd still have our baby girl. Yeah. Our daughter would still have her sister.
Leaked emails highlighting inaction by authorities have prompted the family to speak out.
Hawke's Bay Civil Defence declined our interview request, but in a statement, the Regional Council said evacuations and warnings are matters that will be considered by the independent review into the Civil Defence response.
I think it's very important to mitigate this kind of risk in future, that there is solid corporate accountability.
It's not about vengeance at this point, it's about justice, and it's about making sure it doesn't happen again.
Baby Jack is bringing some comfort, but has his own challenges.
He's supposed to be the only one of us without a broken heart, but unfortunately he has been born with an atrial tachycardia.
A medical journey looms while still coping with deep loss.
I really look forward to getting to know her and her getting to know us a bit better.
Mm.
Just seeing her thrive and develop and become the person she was meant to be.
I want to go back to the day before Valentine's Day and stay there forever.
Turning back time, not an option. It's now about justice. Henry McMullen, One News.